Go. King Sonny and Chief are at the Etowah County, United States Military Memorial. A very well planned out, very well constructed, and very well maintained. United States Military Memorial. In the background here, we have a helicopter, and we have a Navy ship propeller. That's the ocean and the air. King Sonny and I, Chief, have done two videos with the tank that's to our left and not in this particular video's view. To cover the three placards, you've got to the far right, truth will stand. The truth will stand when the whole world's on fire.
Amen.
The next one is 14th Amendment. Folks, that's the most important besides the First Amendment, in my opinion.
Yes.
The First Amendment is freedom of expression, freedom of speech. They want to silence us. They can't silence the truth. It's bigger than they are. They're the villains. They are in contempt of the Ten Commandments given to us by Heavenly Father. No other gods. Worship no thing, only God. No taking his name in vain. No disrespect for the Sabbath. No disrespect for parents. No murder, no adultery, no thieving. Do not kill the truth. No desiring what is not yours. The problem with the Ten Commandments is it pays to break them financially and short term. It pays. You can get rich breaking them, but you'll burn in hell.
Amen.
Psychologically, socially, occupationally, metaphorically, literally, God is good all the time. And he provided these simple commandments. And he also said this, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. All the villains in this Miss Eugenia's justice story have broken every commandment.
Yes.
Every one. And there's approximately 100. They're all white men with a couple of white females. That's Margaret Lacey of Cadence Bank and Miss Hayes of Liberty Bank. All the rest are white males. 98, approximately, out of 100 are white men. I ask that you keep our governor in your prayers always. I mean, in essence, she's like the queen of the state. You know what I mean?
Yes.
That's a good woman, Governor Kay Ivey. God save Governor Kay Ivey. And what does that mean? Protect her, help her, guide her. She's carrying a heavy load. Politically corrupt Alabama, they embarrass Governor Kay Ivey. Sheriff Phil Sims, you owe Governor Kay Ivey an apology. She probably does not have anything to say to you, but you could always write her a letter and just let her know how lost and confused you really are. They want me to be a worried man. They want King Sonny to be a worried man. We are not worried men. They are worried about 30 years in federal prison as a disabled child and disabled elder abuser. You realize that? That's a pretty tough pill to metaphorically swallow, don't you agree?
Yes, sir.
And that's what they're guilty of, is it not, King Sonny?
That is the truth.
Caught trying to steal $1 million prime commercial real property located 1 mile south of Gunnersville Walmart. You'll see an 8-foot-high compound wall, black with a 10-inch cap, gated. It's the only residential gated compound in all of Marshall DeKalb Electric. Why? Why was it built, King Sonny? Who ordered it built? Here we go.
Miss Eugenia did.
No, that's wrong.
Okay. Well, tell me, Chief, I done forgot.
Spiritual Grandpa.
Oh, Spiritual Grandpa, yeah, Brother
Chapel.
Brother
ordered
Chapel.
The compound wall built.
Yes.
Why?
Go ahead.
Chiropractor John Allen Smith sexually assaulted Miss Eugenia's youngest son.
Yes, he did.
And on orders of the police.
Yes.
Powers of the state of Alabama.
Yes, he did.
Folks, the feds are not happy.
No, they're not. They're on our sides now. They believe what we're saying.
Hey, they know it's true.
Yes, sir.
And never, ever underestimate the power of a federal judge.
That's it. That's it. True.
United States District Court Judge Anne Marie Carney Axon deemed us United States trustworthy witnesses.
Yes.
We have spoken the truth. We filed the truth. We have nothing to hide. We're not hiding from nobody.
No.
We're screaming the truth.
Yes.
Marshall County, Alabama, USA is utterly corrupt.
That is true.
And they're killing folks for money.
That's it.
Money, and that's
land,
true.
Whatever they get, lie, steal, cheat, and kill. That's what they're doing.
And they've tried to bury this truth, and they can't bury this truth.
Because we got God on our side. He's got it in his hands.
We have survived a Marshall County, Alabama, USA's mob hit.
Yes, we have.
They ordered us dead.
Yep.
To steal $1 million prime commercial real property through unjust forced bank foreclosure by sabotaging.
Yes.
Violently sabotaging the lives of their hate, theft, sabotage, revenge, disabled targets.
Yes.
Folks, they have violated the American Disability Act.
Yes, they
and
have.
And they have no shelter.
No.
They have no immunity.
No.
They thought they could do what they wanted to whoever they wanted. They thought they could do whatever they wanted to whomever they wanted, anytime they wanted, for as long as they wanted, and just rape, rob, pillage, slander, steal, kill, destroy. And that's not the American way. These people are domestic terrorists.
Yes, they are.
And we are American Alabama cotton farmers.
Yes, we are.
And we are also Lynyrd Skynyrd Southern Rock Band members. We deserve to have and enjoy just as much as
Northeast Alabama. Yes, we are.
My brother is Damon Rogers Johnson, and he is the lead guitarist for Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Yes, he is.
When the lead guitarist was killed in a fiery plane crash 2 months after Elvis Aaron Presley passed away at Graceland, Memphis, Tennessee. Not long after that, Damon Rogers Johnson became the lead guitarist for Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Yes, he has.
And he does a real good job.
Yes, he does.
He was born with that gift. It's God-given. Can't be nothing wrong with it. The way he plays, the way he writes music, the way he sings is God-given.
Yes, it is.
Can't be nothing wrong with it.
No. And it will be not, because he goes by the Ten Commandments.
Yeah, he's a good man.
Yes, he is.
And he's a good father.
Yes, he is.
To five children.
Yep.
And he's a hard worker.
Yes.
And he loves his mother.
Yes, he does, Miss Eugenia.
And Marshall County hates his mother.
Yes.
Because she stopped Marshall County from extorting her for $5 million after the county audited her to determine her net worth.
Yes, they did.
It was a criminal surveillance tactic.
Yes.
When Marshall County ordered Miss Eugenia audited by the State Revenue Department.
And they know how to go after
it. They wanted to know where the cash was.
Yep.
And then they orchestrated, hear me folks, in the name of the living God, they orchestrated a tampered jury.
Yes, they did.
And that's the foundation of the American judicial system, second only to the United States Constitution.
Yes.
First, you have the framework of the United States Constitution. And then that is implemented through the jury system.
Yes.
And Marshall County has an utter disregard for both.
Yes, they do.
And they'll kill you for your land.
Amen, brother. That's the truth.
Now, we're American Alabama cotton farmers.
Yes.
From Berlin, Germany.
Yes.
We're very proud of our German heritage. Our fatherland is Germany.
Yes.
We're not Nazis. We're good Germans. And we're good German Americans.
Yes.
We've been called everything but good people.
That's true.
And if we had done everything we've been accused of doing, we wouldn't have had time for anything.
No, we'd be in jail right now ourselves.
And everything they've accused us of doing, they're guilty of.
That's it. They've done it themselves. We had a preacher to tell us that, been preaching for 51 years around the world. He said, what they claim you done, they've done it more than y'all have.
Abusing children. Not us.
Yeah.
Sheriff Sims abused a 10-year-old boy at Lake Gunnersville State Park.
Yes.
Drugs? Not us.
No.
I've never been high on hard drugs, not one time in my life. The three surgeries I've had don't count.
No.
Because I didn't even take all the medication I was prescribed then.
Yes.
My whole family is anti-intoxicant.
Yep.
We don't believe in pharmaceuticals or alcohol.
No.
As any kind of a medicinal value or any kind of a substance that needs to be put in the body. It's a pollutant.
Yes, it is.
And you find out that these people are raging alcoholics.
Yes.
And rank hypocrites.
Mm-hmm. Amen, brother.
That engage in rank duplicity, which is deceitfulness.
Yes.
Folks, we paid the bankers over, on this one loan, over $100,000. We paid the bankers that have attempted to rob us of $1 million property over $1 million in interest.
Yes.
And we've paid the county of Marshall millions in taxes, primarily sales tax and payroll tax and
yes.
Property land tax just on that one property they're trying to steal.
Yes, they are.
Since we've been there since 2000, and we've never even had a speeding ticket.
No.
They've committed numerous felony crimes, multi-million dollar felony crimes against us.
Yes.
And they've signed their names to these felony crimes.
Yes, they have.
These crooked judges.
Yep.
It's Judge Evans, $5 million extortion scheme. Judge Jolly, $10 million sabotage scheme because Miss Eugenia appealed the $5 million extortion scheme.
Mm-hmm.
And the tamper jury and all of it. And the Supreme Court of Alabama, in essence, told these white supremacists to stand down.
Yes.
And be real still and quiet.
Yes.
Because they're caught.
Yes, they were.
They denied Miss Eugenia her statutory immunity, and they claimed qualified immunity in their $5 million bank robbery.
Yes.
Yeah, she owned a finance company, folks, a 23 office, 36 employee, 3,500 finance customer, privately owned finance company. And Marshall County judges robbed it now twice.
Yes.
And they've sabotaged it four times to yes. bankruptcy.
Yes.
This is how they do it.
Mm-hmm.
With one lie.
Yes.
They called Miss Eugenia a dangerous defamer.
Yes.
They said, you're a liar.
Yes.
That's three words. Y-O-U apostrophe R-E. A liar.
Yes.
L-I-A-R. Three words. And they're trying to rob her of $5 million. They've tampered the jury and convicted an innocent white female, elderly, disabled,
yes.
retired Alabama High School guidance counselor. And did I say she's disabled?
No,
yeah. Yeah, I did. She's got five deteriorated lower back discs from hoeing primarily and picking cotton for the first 20 years of her life.
Yes.
And she graduated Berry College. That is the second most expensive college in Georgia, second only to Emory. And you can expect to spend about $60,000 to go to college for 1 year.
Yes.
What family can afford that? Not many.
No.
That's one. You got to go four to have anything. And then you find out Margaret Lacey of Cadence Bank never went to college.
That's true.
She graduated Memphis High School and she'd had enough of all that.
Yes.
And now she's conspired with the sheriff. And they set out to kill Miss Eugenia through legal discrimination and mob violence.
Yes.
And they killed a World War II war hero and war cripple. He got his left leg was almost blown off with shrapnel.
Yes, it was.
At age 17,
yes.
he volunteered for World War II. And he asked the U.S. military to send him to his fatherland, Berlin, Germany, to fight the Nazis. He was furious. Because his great-grandfather, Kaiser Wilhelm II, had asked Adolf Hitler through his son if he could have a position in the German Nazi government because Brother Chapel's great-grandfather Kaiser Wilhelm II had abdicated the throne in 1918, and he was in exile with many hundreds of millions of dollars because he was the emperor, the last emperor of Germany. They call him a Kaiser in German. And he asked Adolf Hitler through his elder son, who would have been crown prince, but he did not inherit the throne because his father, Kaiser Wilhelm II, abdicated in 1918 because he was blamed for starting, in part, World War I.
That's true.
And what happened there is he tried to stop the trains once they had been deployed with all the soldiers from Russia, Great Britain, and Germany. And he called a day late to the Russian Tsar and the King of England and said, stop the trains. And they said, no, we can't stop the trains, Kaiser. They called him Willie. They were three cousins, quite a historic time. The Tsar of Russia was a cousin to the King of England, was a cousin to the Emperor of Germany. And they got into a big world war. And the very first, which then led to World War II.
It did.
And if Kaiser Wilhelm II had made that call one day sooner to stop the trains, we wouldn't have had World War I.
No.
But anyway, when you're out of time, folks, you're just out of time.
That's it.
Now, we've got time for Alabama to make this right.
Yes.
And we're making it very clear that the good people of Alabama deserve justice.
Yes, they do.
In this case.
Yes.
It's a judicial abomination.
Yes.
And we want to move on with our lives. And we're at the mercy of the powers that be.
Yes, it
and
is.
And who in essence are the powers that be? That's God.
Yes.
That's the U.S. Department of Justice.
Yes.
And that's the general.
Yes, sir.
That's the Office of the Attorney General.
Generals. Yep.
General.
General.
There's one.
Just one.
There's one.
Yes.
The general is Steve Marshall.
Yes.
For Alabama. In this, the 21st century and the year 2023. And he's likened to Robert E. Lee in the Civil War. He is the man.
Yes.
And he's in charge of the Office of the Attorney General.
Yes.
And they've got this case. And King Sonny met with the Office of the Attorney General.
I did.
And told them the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
That is it, because that's what we do.
And they're well aware that we're American Alabama cotton farmers.
Yes.
They're well aware that we're also Lynyrd Skynyrd Southern Rock Band members.
Yes, of Northeast Alabama.
Because Miss Eugenia's eldest son is the lead guitarist, Damon.
Yes.
Damon Rogers Johnson. You can Google his name, Damon Johnson, American guitarist. They're aware that we deserve to have and enjoy just as much as anyone else does.
Yes.
The Marshall County authorities theft targeted us, and as we have resisted, they have set out to sabotage us and then kill us.
Yes, they have.
And this is how they do it, folks. They killed my mother's brother, David Keith Rogers, and that's the Dixie Mafia in Albertville, Alabama, Marshall County. And that occurred August 7th, 1965. And he called Miss Eugenia last. And she was in Macon, Georgia, where her husband, my biological father's grandfather, had been murdered by the sheriff of Macon, Georgia. A Ku Klux Klan member, sheriff.
Yes.
In the moonshine trafficking.
Yes.
Business. And he ordered a deputy to murder my grandpa.
Yes.
Folks, the white supremacists of the South, one in Georgia and about 11 in Alabama, they've murdered 12 of my family members, and three of them are my grandpas.
Yes.
One on my father's side, one on my mother's side, and then our spiritual grandpa, Roger Coit Chapel, a.k.a. Spiritual Grandpa chapel.
Indeed.
And all for money.
Yes.
And or to silence us.
Yes.
So they could keep their illegalities going.
Yes, they did.
But they deem us unworthy of justice and worthy only of theft and abuse. They have abused us.
Yes.
They have misused us.
Yes, sir. Pretty.
And we are just people. We are just living our lives, and these villains, we're forced to fight. They are Tories, T-O-R-I-E-S. They support Toryism, T-O-R-Y-I-S-M, which means they claim to be true American patriots while actually supporting another form of government.
Yes.
Like a monarchy.
Yes.
Or dictatorship.
Yes, sir.
And the term Tory was originated and first used in the Revolutionary War, because there were backstabbing, two-faced hypocrites.
Amen, brother.
Claiming to be advocates of the struggling United States of America when they were actually spies.
Yes, sir.
And they were supporting King George III.
Yes.
Who was the mad king that lost America.
Yes.
Why? Folks, he wanted to be uber white. So he covered his face, his neck, his arms, anything that showed publicly that was not covered in his kingly regalia, as in his crown and his robe. He covered himself with white flour.
Yes.
That had a lead base as for makeup. And that lead got in his bloodstream.
Yes, it did.
And he literally went insane.
Yes.
And then when the United States of America, a ragtag military, beat the Royal Army, the strongest military on earth at the time, that sent him over the edge.
Yes, it did.
And then you got Marshall County attacking the United States yet again. They did in the Civil War, when they fired on Fort Sumter in April,
yeah,
1861, they fired on the United States of America because they didn't get their way.
No.
And they were willing to kill the United States to steal the southern half of the North American continent.
Yes.
Didn't work out well for the South.
No.
The United States was five times more populated up north than down south.
Yes, they were.
Do the math, folks. They were outnumbered.
Yes.
5-1. Real simple. Get you a pen and paper. There are three figures. There were 22 million white northerners, 4 million African-American southerners, and 5 million white southerners.
Yes.
So you got 5 million white southerners taking on 26 million.
True.
American patriots.
Yes.
Did not work out good. It never should have happened.
No.
It should have been mediated. Abraham Lincoln said, look, we're going to pay a livable wage, abolish chattel slavery, as all of Europe has done in essence at the time, because of the cruelties of chattel slavery.
Yes.
And it's not going to cost you anything, because you're going to simply raise the cost of goods sold, which means you're going to increase the cost of cotton and pay the African Americans a livable wage.
Yes.
What would have been a livable wage then? Probably metaphorically $1 a day.
Yes.
I mean, Henry Ford was made world news when he began paying $5 a day for his workers to create the Ford automobile.
Mm-hmm.
But Alabama wasn't going to have it. They wanted to use gunfire, firearms, to steal the southern half of the North American continent from Washington, D.C., and then use firearms to force the African Americans to work for free.
Yes.
Slave labor. So there they are with thievery in their nature.
Yes.
How could they be so cruel, so ignorant, and so satanic? Well, folks, they rationalize it with dangerous religious dogma.
Yeah.
And we don't go by the Old Testament. We go by the restored gospel.
Yes.
We understand the power and the complete and unlimited power of the atonement of Christ Jesus.
Amen, brother.
And they mock the Lord, these radical Baptists, and they engage in spiritual and religious, not just nonsense, insanity.
Yes.
So they took a verse out of the Old Testament that said a slave should respect his master and thereby receive favor from the master. So they said, well, God wants us to have chattel slaves, regardless of what the United States says. How can you be so cruel to disregard the president of the United States? Order.
That's true.
I mean, respect the office, you know?
Yes.
Respect the position.
Yes.
Respect the badge.
Yes.
Of law enforcement.
Yes.
America's a nation of laws.
Yes, they are.
And Marshall County, Alabama, USA, they've embarrassed the governor.
Yep.
And the general.
Yes, they got their own laws.
Yeah,
they go by the Bible, they said. But it's the wrong Bible. It's the devil's Bible.
That's right.
They go to church with their Bibles under their arms. Sheriff does, Phil Sims. Margaret Lacey totes hers. They sit in the pew, you know, amen this, amen that. They put money in the collection plate. They think that's going to get them to heaven. You do not buy your way to heaven.
I promise you, Governor Kay Ivey knows the good Bible.
That's true. That's
it. And I promise you, she's a good faith Christian.
Yes, she is.
I know she is. Yes.
And they have disappointed her, Marshall County has, with the corruption that they have caused, which they're caught. You know, the FBI and Attorney General and God has got them.
Because look, she's an elderly white woman herself. She's about Miss Eugenia's age.
She is. She is.
She knows exactly what Miss Eugenia feels like.
Yes.
And now she's lost her husband.
Yes.
When Miss Eugenia's husband passed away July the 11th, 2020, and a death certificate was filed with the state, the violence escalated against her.
That's it, because they knew she was single widower and tried to take everything she had because she didn't have nobody to back her.
And they tried to put her youngest son, her protector, and her chief, in jail on trumped up charges.
Yeah, alcohol.
Narcotics, folks. This man right here, you don't want to go up against this man right here. That's King Sonny.
Yes.
He is the only one of two living official original bodyguards to the one, the only, Elvis Aaron Presley.
Amen, brother, I am.
And he is well aware of how Phil Sims ordered and or condoned Elvis Aaron Presley's image and likeness to be not just defamed, but sullied in the most vile and perverted manner. It's just absolutely unthinkable, unconscionable, and unfathomable. And unconscionable, it just shocks the conscience of a fair-minded, reasonable human that they would have Elvis being portrayed in an adulterous affair with another, in a same-sex affair, and then using a wooden baseball bat in this sexual, it's just an adult X-rated comedy skit.
On stage
at the Lake Gunnersville State Park Lodge, which is the crown jewel for the Alabama State Park system.
Yes.
And it's a priceless, you could probably build it for, I don't know, $50 billion?
I would say yes.
I mean, it's a lot of acreage and yes, all that, but you couldn't buy it. Money can't buy it. It's the crown jewel of the Alabama State Park System.
Yes.
And what happened is, George C. Wallace and Lurline Wallace,
amen, brother,
built that. Yes, their names are on that property.
Yes.
We have that because of them.
Yes.
And then you've got Sheriff Phil Sims defaming the late Gunnersville State Park Lodge.
Amen, brother. He did.
And defaming beyond belief. That's what unfathomable means.
Yes.
It means it's believable, but impossible to understand.
Yes, it is.
How a sheriff, and shortly after he was elected, could engage in such diabolical behavior. Amen. And folks, don't be confused. Just follow the money. It was all designed to steal a $1 million prime commercial real property from an elderly woman that had stopped the county from robbing her of $5 million cash.
That's true, brother. Tell it, Chief.
And that's the truth.
That is the truth. So help us God.
And as she resisted, and her chief financial officer and spiritual grandpa resisted, and her youngest son and chief executive officer resisted, the fifth takedown, we call them tsunami waves of violence. Yes. What it really is the Marshall County, Alabama, USA officials mafia mob hit. They just took out a mob hit on us.
Yes, they did.
And for the fifth time.
Yes.
We are lucky to be alive.
That's it. Bring it on, brothers, because we ain't going nowhere.
And they killed Brother Chapel.
True.
And they sexually abused a 10-year-old boy.
Yes.
Of an emotional nature.
Yes.
Who goes to these events dressed as Elvis.
Yes.
And he has won numerous Elvis Tribute Artist Awards in his age group.
Yes.
And he, his first Graceland, first place award was when he was 5 years old.
Yes.
And he was 10 when Sheriff Phil Sims had him strategically placed next to me, Chief, in order to execute an adult X-rated comedy skit in the Camilla Ballroom and with an Elvis tribute artist that's a two-time world champion.
That's right, brother.
David Lee Roseberry.
Yes.
He betrayed Elvis Aaron Presley.
Yes, he did.
He betrayed George C. Wallace and Lurline Wallace. He betrayed the good people of Alabama.
Our governor especially.
But you got to understand, Phil Sims is threatening him with, if you're ever going to work here,
you're
going to have to do our bidding.
Yes.
So, folks, it's the mafia, and they're in control with power and authority.
Oh, they think they are, Chief.
They currently are, and we need God, and we need the United States Department of Justice, and we need the Office of the Attorney General.
Yes.
To just remain in atonement with Christ Jesus, remain in conscious contact with God, prayerfully, and God will guide them and protect them through this to manifest justice for all.
Yes.
It's a teachable moment.
Yes, it is. It's going to be teachable for them.
It's an utter disregard to the Constitution on many levels.
Yes, it is.
And it is a violation of the American Disability Act, which eliminates their qualified immunity.
Yes.
These officials just think they're above the law.
Yeah, above God, really.
And above God. They think, you know, we'll offer them their life. Oh, yeah, they'll give us their $1 million property, or we'll kill them. We'll threaten to kill them. Well, that's what they did, folks.
They're trying to, yeah.
That's what that's not their place. They're not God.
No.
But they think they are.
Yes.
And that's what they said.
Yes.
In essence.
Yeah, they have.
By their actions.
Yes.
We'll offer them their life.
That's it.
Who do they think they are that they can offer us our life? They didn't make us. And we don't owe our life to them.
No.
We owe our life to God.
That's it, brother.
And that story ends right there.
Yes.
We don't fear any human.
No.
We fear and love the Lord.
Yes. We're in His hands, both of them. So, public, you know, which we appreciate you watching our videos and sharing it with everyone you can to get them to listen to it. And when you do, you understand what we're going through and how the Marshall County sheriffs, bankers, judges, just every one of them is in the office in Marshall County. Ain't nothing but a bunch of, you know, thieves, lies, steal, and cheat, and kill.
And they killed who?
Brother Spiritual Chapel. That's what they done. A World War II veteran, a high priest, and a healer at 95 years old that wouldn't hurt a flea.
And hey, I've got photos of him. I've seen photos of him. He was a, I don't know, probably about 6'3".
Yeah.
150 pounds.
Yes, sir.
Blonde-haired, blue-eyed German.
Yes.
Signing up voluntarily.
Yes.
From Connecticut and asking the United States military to send him to his fatherland so he can fight the Nazis.
Yes.
And he went to the Pacific, ordered there to fight Hirohito. You got to understand, Japan, Hirohito, and Germany, Adolf Hitler, both declared the declaration of war against the United States.
They did, Chief.
And it opened the Pandora's box of methamphetamine.
Yes.
Because Adolf Hitler had a Japanese chemist create a tool of war.
Yes.
Which was methamphetamine.
Yes. And
it was designed for a one-way ticket to hell.
Yes. The devil's hell.
And those soldiers were never expected to return.
No.
And the recipe got out.
Yes.
And now we've got the zombified walking dead.
Yes.
Because they do that one time and damage their brain.
Yes.
Methamphetamine was designed and given to Nazi soldiers and the Emperor of Japan's soldiers. And they were sent into war as kamikaze pilots and kamikaze soldiers.
They did.
They were given near lethal doses, liquefied methamphetamine, and a metal container with about 12 or 24 syringes in it.
Yes.
They were never expected to live.
No.
And most did not.
No.
When they did the meth, it made them feel 10 feet tall and bulletproof. But then they were killed in war by Russia, Great Britain, and the United States of America.
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, when the methamphetamine recipe got out, now these people are doing it and damaging their brain and living.
Yes.
And then they create chaos for the rest of their lives.
Yes,
and
they
there's do. There's no cure.
No.
And they've got a 10% chance to remain clean.
Yes.
So for anyone that has ever ingested methamphetamine, I pray for you.
Yes, we do.
I pray for you, and I pray that you'll remain drug-free.
Please, yes.
Please, do it for the world.
Yes.
Do it for yourself.
Do it
for yourself, and also do it for the world.
Yes,
because you make the world hell.
Yes.
With your lying, thieving, conniving, chaos-creating,
yes,
nonsense.
That's true, Chief. But Chief, I'm going to close this out with a prayer here because we have covered every one
of
our bases.
We're 44 minutes in.
Well, that's good.
I want to cover one thing, if I may, and then we'll close it out with a prayer.
Okay.
This is a nod, so to speak, to the females that have just so happened to appear in this story. The first is our A-plus trial lawyer, and that's the United States attorney, Miss Escalana.
Yes.
At the Birmingham U.S. District Attorney's Office. She's very qualified.
Yes.
And she graduated magna cum laude and Phi Beta Kappa.
Yes.
Now that's a legal genius.
Yes, it
if you,
is.
If you don't know, that's a legal genius right there.
Yes.
She's well qualified, and we ask you to keep her also in your prayers.
Yes, please.
Prayer changes things, folks.
It does.
It's beyond human comprehension.
Yes.
It changes molecules. It changes atoms. It changes things. Literally, it changes people's minds.
Yes.
And the more people pray on the same thing, the more powerful it is.
It's God backing it. That's it, what it is.
Say that again.
I said it's God backing everything because he's got the power to do everything.
So I just want to briefly mention the five females influencing Miss Eugenia's justice. Number one, we'll go with the Alabama top leader, and that's Governor Kay Ivey.
Yes.
Number two is the United States Attorney, Miss Escalona.
Yes.
And that's at the Birmingham United States District Attorney's Office. And then number three, well, you've got, what is her name? Jennifer Bray. And that's the recently elected District Attorney for Marshall County. We commend Marshall County for electing the first county district attorney ever.
Yes.
As a female.
Yes, sir.
And now we want five female judges to replace these white supremacists.
Amen, brother.
And we need a female judge for Albertville City to replace that white supremacist.
Yes.
And I call them that because of what they've done to my mother.
Yes.
Miss Eugenia. They've all attacked her.
Yes.
Relentlessly, repeatedly, and they've destroyed at least and provably $25 million.
Amen, brother.
Provably. That's Federal Credit Finance Corporation. That's First Credit Finance Corporation. That's Free and Clear Realty. And that's more recently First Credit Auto. First Credit Auto alone has $1.3 to $1.5 million in financial damage because of this most recent and fifth tsunami wave of violence.
Yes.
By these white supremacists that are the judges, the lawyers, the bankers, the chiropractors, the commercial real estate professionals. They rig the system, folks. They rig the jury. And the feds are going to put them all in federal prison for a long time.
Yes.
But, you know, there's a fourth female that has recently been placed in office. And I'm telling you, change.
Yes.
Is happening in Northeast Alabama. People realize these white men have gone way over the line.
Yes, they have.
They're just criminals.
See it.
With credentials, and no home is safe. They're ordering people raped and robbed, pillaged and slandered and set on fire and their cars tampered with, blind people abused and tormented like King Sonny for
That's five and a half hours,
a 10-year-old boy emotionally abused of a sexual nature at the Lake Gunnersville State Park Lodge, a World War II war-disabled high priest killed, and an Alabama cotton farmer's daughter.
Yes.
Utterly.
Yes.
Destroyed. They ordered her destroyed.
Yes, they have.
Because they theft targeted her. And the Supreme Court stopped them in a $5 million extortion scheme, and they came back to kill her.
Yes.
They sabotaged $10 million. That's Judge Jolly in a 9-month business license stall, threatening her with state prison if she engaged in so much as one finance transaction without a license.
Yes.
And the law said you're to resolve any license dispute within 30 days. And Timothy Jolly arrogantly said, I just have no time on my calendar for a 20-minute hearing. If she qualified as she did in 9 months for business license, she qualified in 9 seconds.
Yes.
And they did that because she appealed the $5 million extortion scheme against the white supremacists of Northeast Alabama, the modern-day Dixie Mafia. They're called the Marshall County Mafia.
Yes.
They killed Buford Pusser.
Yes, they did.
You can go up there and find that out. Employees don't want that on camera. But the truth will stand when the whole world's on fire.
That's it.
And why would they hire the Dixie Mafia to kill a Tennessee sheriff? You want to know the answer?
Please.
Because the county number was the same.
Yes, that's right.
50 Sheriff Buford Pusser.
Yes.
They called him Buford the Bull.
Yep.
County 50 Sheriff. And Marshall County is County 50. Dixie Mafia, now Marshall County Mafia.
Yes.
It's just a criminal syndicate of backwoods thugs.
Yes, it is.
And they're killing white folks.
Now, yes.
For money like they did the African Americans 100+ years ago.
Yep.
And more recent. They
yes.
do it. They do it. You know they do it. They rigged the juries and celebrated and hooped and hollered in those courtrooms all over Alabama. And those African Americans had to sit there and watch that.
Yes.
Knowing the evidence proved murder against their beloved African-American family members. Children, minor children. We're talking 11 years old and three 14-year-old girls at
That's
the
right,
16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham. 19 sticks. I thought it was 16.
16.
I was told 16 and then I was told 19.
Okay.
Regardless, it blew the whole side of the church out.
Yes,
and it blew the side of adjoining buildings out. That's domestic terror, and this is domestic terror by domestic terrorists. These people are going to probably be charged with domestic terrorism.
Yes.
I don't think they'll ever get out of prison.
No.
But you got the Albertville City prosecuting attorney, a female, that was appointed just recently. Pray for her. And then you have Miss Eugenia. Herself is number 5. So real quick, just to recap that, you got 5 females, and you can't leave out Kamala Harris. I don't care your political leanings. These are high-powered women with power and authority. You don't cross these women.
No.
Because they know the law, they love the Lord, and they will bring justice into reality. And if you're on the wrong side of the Constitution or the wrong side of the Bible, that's the legal Bible,
yes.
The U.S. Constitution. All of our military blood and treasure has been expended to support and defend the United States Constitution. It's that simple.
It's true.
You are not going to disregard it. Every syllable, every word, every comma, every period is sacred to me as it was Hugo L. Black. Read those plaques at the Hugo L. Black Federal Courthouse, the Civil Rights Courthouse in Birmingham, Alabama. That's a multi-billion dollar property. And Marshall County has an utter disregard for the entire United States Constitution, which is the legal Bible, and an utter disregard for the Holy Bible. Which, if they just followed the Ten Commandments,
yes,
they would have never committed one of these crimes against
no.
humanity and against the disabled. That's what got them, folks. Give a fool enough rope, and they'll hang themselves.
That's it, brother.
Pray for these villains that they don't hurt anyone else and that they don't hurt themselves. There is a place where the light will not find you. Yet that is in a grave.
Yes.
Like Brother Chapel.
That's right.
And we do not want you to hurt yourself like you tried to hurt us.
Yes.
So to recap real quick, and I'll close it out with the quickest prayer I know. And then I'll let a professional prayer commence. The five females in the Miss Eugenia's Justice story is number one, Governor Kay Ivey.
Yes.
And you really could say Kamala Harris, Vice President of the United States, respect the office. She was the Attorney General for California for, I don't know, maybe two decades. Yeah. But I promise you, she knows the nature of humankind without God. The ego is self-destructive, and she took child abuse as her most prosecuted crime.
Yes.
That was her specialty, is to bring child abusers to justice.
Yes.
In California. You got Kamala Harris, the Vice President of the United States. We've never had a vice president as a United States vice president. We've never had but one female governor in Alabama, and that was Governor George C. Wallace's wife, Lurline Wallace.
Amen,
a
brother.
Fine governor.
Yes.
Gone too soon.
Yes.
I think she was 41 and passed away with cancer. She's with us in spirit.
Amen.
She's on our side.
Yes.
George C. Wallace is too.
Yes, he is.
So you've got Kamala Harris, Vice President of the United States. You got Governor Kay Ivey, the Governor of Alabama. Then you got the U.S. Attorney for Alabama, which is Miss Escalona. That's three. And then you've got Jennifer Bray, the District Attorney in Marshall County. That's four. Then you've got the Albertville City prosecuting female attorney now, just recently, and that's five. Then you got Miss Eugenia. But she's in a category all by herself. She's the victim.
Yes.
But you've really got five high-powered females all assisting Miss Eugenia's justice.
Yes.
Which is your justice, which is humanity's justice. These crimes cannot be tolerated. A precedent will be set, and U.S. District Court Judge Brian Turner said, I'm familiar with Miss Eugenia's civil rights case with U.S. District Court Judge Axon. Those aren't his exact words. He just said, I'm familiar with your civil rights case with Judge Axon. It's historic. Thank you for that. I didn't really know what it meant. Did
you?
I looked it up. I mean, I had an idea, but I thought, how is it historic when it has just been filed? Well, historic is important or potentially important to history. And another judge, a family court judge in Greenville, South Carolina, my uncle, Timmy Brown, retired now, about 35-year family court judge in Greenville, South Carolina. He knows the nature of humans. Without God, they're diabolical more times than not. And he said this case will be taught in law schools, and that'll be for at least the next 50 years, if not more. So folks, God wrote the script, and just remember, they came for 5 million, they sabotaged 10 million, then Miss Margaret Lacey gave away $40,000 to sabotage Miss Eugenia's ability to pay her mortgage. Then Miss Margaret Lacey, a high school diploma recipient but no college education from Memphis, came to Marshall County, also known as Meth Mountain.
Amen, brother.
And conspired with a new sheriff she helped get elected. And then both of them are going around bragging they're going to sabotage a 95-year-old World War II veteran and an 83 cotton farmer daughter's lives to steal $1 million property through sabotage. Because
yes.
The mortgage was paid down to $40,000. Wow. That's how they do it, folks. Imagine paying 24 years on a 30-year mortgage, and your banker and your sheriff and your corporate attorney, Jimmy Carnes, and your other banker that you've been a banker with for going on 50 years. Ms. Eugenia was a founding depositor before the president, Chris Bailey, was born.
Yes.
She was a depositor at Liberty Bank, and he ran her out of the bank when she caught him trying to steal $1 million, conspiring with another banker, Margaret Lacey, and her corporate attorney, Jimmy Carnes, all stalling and stonewalling and lying. Lying and writing and cheating.
Yes.
And the sheriff bragging that he's going to get those 14 garages.
No.
I didn't even know that there were 14 garages at Miss Eugenia's. 10745 U.S. Highway 431 South, Albertville, Alabama, 35950 USA. First Credit Finance Corporation in the front and the Monroe compound in the back.
Yes.
It's mixed-use status that was grandfathered in from the 70s. That means there's commercial office space in the front, and in the back, you enter the compound through a gate, a solid 8-foot-high, 30-foot-long gate, electric. And that's a residential apartment area. And there are 14 automobile garages on that property. And the sheriff was bragging that he was going to steal the 14 garages and give the property to his antique car club buddies that who also helped him become sheriff. And he and his banker friend are going to steal the property together through the first mortgage. He's going to serve the foreclosure papers that he created. He created the foreclosure, was their plan. Folks, we've never been late on a mortgage payment. We're not going to lose $1 million property over a $40,000 balance. These people thought it was going to be quick and easy. They thought they were going to win and get rich.
Yes.
And then you've got a corrupt judge, Mitchell Floyd, threatening Brother Chapel with jail because he asked for a fair and impartial trial regarding the John Allen Smith sexual assault against Miss Eugenia's youngest son.
Yes.
That's all to steal $1 million property, folks. We've never been mistreated like this. And this means the day, the unfortunate day, that fateful day, Sheriff Phil Sims was elected.
Amen, brother.
November 3rd, 2018, all hell broke loose.
Yes.
On Sand Mountain. Bring in the Union Cavalry.
Yes.
Bring in the United States Cavalry.
Yes.
And stop this madness on Meth Mountain. Folks, his son was arrested shortly after he was elected in Coleman County on meth charges. It's a tragedy, but that's what we've been told from reliable sources and numerous sources. We've all but also been told other things regarding the theft of lawn care equipment through the Marshall County Sheriff's Department and the stolen property traded for guns, including firearms.
Yes.
Traded for drugs and sold in pawn shops. A tragedy, folks. A real tragedy. Then you have Mitchell Floyd also rendering a $5,000 bias. According to two Alabama attorneys, they in essence said he's a fire-breathing bias judge. Do you realize any form of discrimination is a crime? Do you realize this legal discrimination and mob violence killed Brother Chapel?
It did.
Got Miss Eugenia's youngest son, me, sexually assaulted, and I thereby acquired a PTSD, which is hellish. How has it changed me? They also abused a 10-year-old boy and this blind man. They tormented him.
Yes.
All trying to steal $1 million property from an elderly, disabled 83-year-old Alabama high school retired guidance counselor who stopped them from trying to steal $5 million cash.
Yes.
That's the real Marshall County, Alabama, USA, officials mafia.
Yes.
100 people, in essence. Tampered juries, crooked judges, 5 crooked judges, 1 crooked city judge and 5 crooked county judges, 10 crooked lawyers, all from Marshall County, all filed with the state bar. Couple of crooked chiropractors filed with the Alabama Chiropractic Board, but only one was filed against formally. And then we filed against John Allen Smith with every consumer protection agency, including the ABI. They all wanted to just sweep it under the rug. They were complicit with the sexual assault.
Yes.
Folks, you gotta understand, you get 10 years for the civil rights violation in federal custody. You get another 10 if you're engaged in a conspiracy that involves sexual assault or the threat of sexual assault. So for John Allen Smith, if you're thinking that it cannot be proven, you don't realize a Jefferson County jury just has to believe the threat of sexual assault occurred.
Yes.
And then another 10 years is added to every member of the conspiracy.
Yes.
Not just you, John Allen Smith, chiropractor, right next to the Albertville City Police Magistrate's office at the time, providing free unlimited chiropractic services to any minor child in the Albertville High School Athletic Department. They abused you, America, when they abused us.
Yes.
Go ahead. I'll close it with the quickest prayer. Oh, God, thank you for everything. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, you go ahead and close it. Thank you, son.
Yeah. Chief, you hit a lot of good points.
Loud
right
and
there.
Clear.
I said you hit a lot of good points right there, and okay. Every one of them told the truth.
Okay, well, I want to close, if I may, with just the most favorite Bible verse.
Go right ahead.
And that is St. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Amen, brother.
Go ahead.
The truth.
Close it out.
But dear Lord, what the chief said there about, you know, from the sheriff all the way down to the crooked judges is God's truth. Because we tell the truth, because we know God, we believe in God, we got the Spirit, and we tell the truth. But dear Lord, you know, we want you to, you know, if they want to come to you and confess that they done wrong, let them get on both knees, both hands, head bowed, let that tongue confess for forgiveness, if you will, because we can't do it. You're the only one that can. And when they do ask forgiveness, we'd like for to see them get saved and baptized. And the main thing, get washed in the blood.
Amen.
Because that's what it is, God. You know it's what it is because Jesus bled. And that's what cleansed the world for sins from now on until he comes back.
And these rogue Christians must be brought back under the blood of the covenant.
Yes, that's true, Chief.
They've already been baptized.
Yes.
It's apostasy.
Yes.
They're guilty of.
Oh, yes, it is.
The unforgivable.
Yeah, and they're going to be took care of because God and the FBI and, you know, and all three of the high powers plus us, you know, because we go by the book, the real book, God's Bible, not the devil's, as they do. But dear Lord, you like you just read, you sent your only begotten Son. You know, when they put the cross on his back and toted it up the hill, they beat him, they whipped him. They didn't think he could make it, but he did because he had your faith. He never looked back and kept going straight. When he got to the top, they nailed him to it, tied him to it, then rose him up. He was looking at everybody, and he said, God, they do not know what they do. You know, he asked for their forgiveness. And one of the soldiers stuck his sword in his side. Well, spear. That's where the blood come in. And Jesus died on the cross. But he told them, 3 days I will rise and come out. 3 days later, he come out. The angels opened up the rock and Jesus walked out. Walked among earth just a little and started rising to the sky. He's right now sitting on the right hand side of God. Because God, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost is all three the same person.
Amen.
Yes, they are. And I can't wait when Jesus comes back, because when I open up my door every morning, it's facing east. I can't see, but if he comes down, I will be able to see when I get to heaven. Because he's going to take all my pain, everything away from me. What I got here on earth, it ain't going with me. I don't want it. Because what I want is to be with God and the rest of my family, Miss Gladys, Elvis, Brother Chapel, and the ones that's gone on before me and my family, and the Cheese family and Brother Chapel. I want to see that young man again. You know, I'll be able to visually see him this time. We'll be up on the road of gold, you know, dancing, singing gospel music. Then, you know, there's going to be the gate into heaven. Who's going to be standing there but God? He'll let us in, and when we get inside there, we won't ever want for nothing, because everything we want will be there for us. So, dear God, I'm going to close this out, you know, and thank you for sending your only begotten Son to do our chores, you know, take our sins. And, dear Lord, I ask this in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Amen.
I want to hear Bad Boys.
You want to hear Bad Boys?
Okay. I want to hear Bad Boys.
All right, we'll do that. I want to rip through the Shepherd's Psalm real quick. Just hold that microphone. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 23.
Amen, brother. That's a beautiful verse. Yes, it is.
We are offering Alabama an opportunity to atone for what Alabama has done.
Yes.
We bring the big gun, folks, and that's love.
And that's God.
And that is God. We tell people they are beautiful, they belong, and they are loved regardless of their address, their education, their race, their gender, their age, their disability, their finances, or their religion. We are each children of God.
Amen.
And we say, come as you are, yet not with a lie.
No.
Now, one more time, what song would you like to hear?
Bad Boys, please.
Okay, Steve. Let's hit it. Let me have that microphone. Thank you. We got that right here.
What you gonna do when they come for you? wanna give you no break. Not even your eyes, you're not giving you no breaks. Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?
That was good, and thank all of you for your support too. We really do appreciate you, and you feel free to contact us anytime. And I don't know what else to say. If you got any other statements or questions, King Sonny, go ahead and give them your phone number. Holler it out, even without the
mic. My phone number, if you want to call me 24/7, it don't matter day or night. King Sonny. 256-295-4954.
One more time.
256-295-4954. Call me anytime, day or night. My phone never leaves me.
Please call.
One more time.
Please call. You know, 256-295-4954. Call anytime you want to call.
All right, folks. That's good. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right, appreciate that.
Yeah,
appreciate that. Thank you.